Two middleweights step into the ring. Both weigh exactly 70 kilograms. One's tall and lanky at 180 centimeters. The other's compact and muscular at 165. Traditional boxing wisdom says they should hit with similar power. After all, they're in the same weight class. But new research just revealed which fighter will absolutely demolish the other in a contest of power. Scientists measured punch power across 69 amateur boxers and discovered the physical trait that matters three times more than body mass for generating knockout power. For over 100 years, boxing has organized itself around one undeniable principle. Heavier fighters hit harder. Weight classes exist for this very reason, because a 20 kilogram advantage directly translates to a devastating punch power difference. That's basic physics. But this doesn't explain vast power differences between fighters of equal mass. The traditional training wisdom just couldn't explain it. Pinto and his research team realized we were missing a crucial piece of the puzzle. While previous studies had looked at individual factors like muscle strength or body weight, this was the first comprehensive analysis of how anthropometric characteristics, muscle power, and strength performance actually interact to create punch power. The researchers were literally mapping uncharted territory. 69 male amateur boxers with at least 1 year of training experience were recruited for the comprehensive punch power analysis. Here's what made this study bulletproof. They measured every physical variable that could possibly matter, organized into two categories. First, body characteristics: height, arm span, body mass, and BMI, because striking power starts with leverage, reach, and mass. Second, athletic performance tests that directly translate to punch power. The counter movement jump for explosive leg power, one repetition max bench press for upper body strength, and grip strength. But here's the game changer. They used the Power Cube system. This isn't some gym bag with a crude sensor. It's a scientifically validated 3 kilogram device with dual accelerometers that measures actual punch power in watts. No guessing, no subjective scoring, just pure objective physics. And it's revealed some devastating findings, which we'll get to in just a moment. Every boxer threw both straight punches and hook punches, while the Power Cube captured the exact moment of impact. Then came the brilliant part: correlation analysis and linear regression to determine which physical traits actually predict punch power. Here's where everything we thought we knew about boxing gets turned upside down. Body height emerged as the king of punch power predictors. Tall fighters generated significantly more impact power in both straight punches and hook punches. Height alone explained 36% of the variance in straight punch power, and up to 34% of hook punch variance. Now here's the kicker. Body mass, what determines your weight class, explained only 10% of straight punch power, and 11% of hook punch power. Height predicts punch power three times better than body weight. Among the strength and power tests, bench press absolutely dominated, explaining 38% of straight punch variance and an incredible 51% of hook punch variance. Counter movement jump performance, your explosive leg power, explained 31% of straight punch variance, supporting the kinetic chain theory that power starts from the ground up. But here's what shocked the researchers. BMI actually showed negative correlations with relative punch power. Being heavy for your height doesn't make you hit harder, it makes you less efficient. So what does this mean for coaches and athletes? The research reveals a three-pillar training approach for maximizing punch power. First, integrated strength and power development, combining plyometric training for lower body explosiveness with resistance training for upper body strength. This addresses the kinetic chain from the ground to the fist that the data clearly demonstrates. Second, the study reveals a critical insight about body composition. For athletes with higher BMI, training programs must balance absolute power with relative performance efficiency. Adding mass without proportional strength gains actually reduces your power to weight ratio, making you less effective. Third, coordination training focusing on force transfer optimization. The researchers emphasize exercises that enhance agonist-antagonist cooperation, essentially teaching your body to coordinate the complex sequences that turn leg power into devastating punch impact. But here's what most programs miss: grip strength training. The researchers found this directly correlates with punch impact, yet it's often overlooked. You can't transfer power through weak links in your striking chain. Lastly, this research changes everything for talent scouts. Height, reach, and bench press strength are the best predictors of punch power. A tall fighter with exceptional upper body strength and a long reach has the physical blueprint for knockout power. This research comes from Influence of Anthropometric Characteristics and Muscle Performance on Punch Impact by Manuel Pinto and colleagues, published in Sports, Volume 13, Issue 8, August 2025. You will find the full link and citation in the show notes. Sports is an open access journal published under the Creative Commons licensing. Thanks for listening to Sports Science Decoded, where we take you from research to application in 5 minutes. If you enjoyed the show, please consider following. Sports Science Decoded is available on YouTube and all major podcast platforms, with episodes Wednesday and Friday. If you have a sports science paper you'd like us to break down in this format, email us. Details are in the show notes. And if you're with a journal or publication interested in research, communication, or partnerships, we'd love to hear from you.